Investment decision making using Excel. This video is the second in a series discussing the essentials of investment decision making. This video discusses cash flow, incremental analysis, net present value, and internal rate of return. Cash flow is the movement of money in and out of a business or an account. Examples include personal checking account, company's cash flow statement, tabulation of a project's costs and revenues. A business's cash flow, also called the operating cash flow, is a firm's net earnings tallied after the company pays taxes and adds back accounting depreciation. A project cash flow is a series of values that reflects the investment used to initiate a project and the net revenue stream generated by the investment. Mathematically, the net cash flow for each period of time, given in years or months, consists of revenue or savings, less production and delivery costs, less taxes, less capital. It is helpful to show money gained, that is, coming in as positive numbers, and money spent as negative values, that is, going out. Capital is the money spent at the beginning of a project to build or buy an asset, which later generates revenue or savings. In this bar chart, the first two red bars with negative numbers represent the investment made at time zero and year one, and the subsequent blue bars and positive numbers in years two through five reflect income. Another idea important to finance is incremental analysis. Many projects represent only a small part of a much larger business. As a business owner, project sponsor, or analyst, you need to understand the incremental costs and revenue associated with each portion of a project. You'll want to control investment capital so as to ensure that each dollar provides value. You should avoid lumping non-essential work with profit-making elements. Failing to do this can result in gold plating, which is the unnecessary overspending on portions of the project. Now let's talk about net present value, which is one of the most important decision-making tools. The net present value, NPV, is the revenue or savings derived from an investment less its cost. Future values are brought back to the present at a compound interest rate called the discount rate. People the world over use net present value because it provides a sense of how much money a project will generate, but it also represents the best tool for deciding among mutually exclusive projects. But we're getting ahead of ourselves. Let's postpone discussing the application of net present value to decision making until another video. For now, let's focus on how to calculate the net present value. The net present value is defined at a particular discount rate. This discount rate is also called the cost of capital, opportunity cost of capital, hurdle rate, minimum rate of return, and minimum acceptable rate of return. The term discount rate implies the idea of discounting the future by bringing money back to the present. The cost of capital is a company's average cost of borrowing money and raising equity. The opportunity cost of capital conveys the thought that an investment opportunity possesses a cost. The term hurdle rate imparts the notion that investments must surpass a minimum acceptable return. This minimum acceptable return is the minimum rate of return. Whatever the language, the concept is the same. We'll now look at an example. You can find the Microsoft Excel workbook that accompanies this video at toweringskills.com/docs/FA002.xlsx. Select example 1 on tab 1. This sheet illustrates a simple discounted cash flow. Line 3 provides the discount rate. Line 5 shows the project years. Line 6 shows the revenue. Line 7 shows the production and delivery costs. Line 8 shows the income, which is found by summing the revenue and the negative production and delivery costs. Line 9 shows the income tax. We won't go into the complexity of how income tax is calculated at this point. Line 10 shows the capital, also entered as a negative number. Note that all costs, which include taxes and capital, are entered as negative numbers. On line 11, the cash flow is the sum of lines 8, 9, and 10. Line 13 provides the discount factors. They're calculated from the discount rate using the formula 1 divided by 1 plus the interest rate taken to the power of the year. This is the compound interest factor we discussed in the prior video. Line 14 shows the discounted cash flow, which is obtained by multiplying the cash flow times the discount factor. Each value in line 14 represents the value converted into present dollars at time zero. Line 15 is the cumulative discounted cash flow. Later we'll see how to use these values. At cell C17, the net present value is calculated using the Excel MPV function. This function's terms include the interest rate and a range of values, which starts with the first discounted period and continues to the last period, or in other words, from cell D11 through H11. Because the MPV function discounts the first period, we must exclude time zero from the function and add time zero's cash flow as a separate item. Let's move to the right and insert the MPV function again. Excel provides a number of ways to enter the function. The easiest method is to select a cell, type the equal sign, and type the name of the function. In this case, equal sign NPV, and then press Tab. Now we need to enter the interest rate or select a cell containing the interest rate. In our case, it's cell B3. I'll now type a comma to move us to the next parameter, and we'll now select the range of undiscounted cash flows, and then close that with a close paren, and we'll now also add the time zero value, which is in cell C11. This number is the same that we have in cell C17. If you need more help, you can access the function wizard by going to the formula bar located just below the command ribbon and clicking on the function icon. In the search for a function box, you can type NPV and then click go. Or you could use select a category and go to the function area and then scroll down until you find NPV and then click OK. This opens the function arguments window. Here you can enter the interest rate and monetary values, or click on the up arrows and navigate to the cells containing the interest rate and monetary values. And of course, we'll add the time zero capital. Again, we end up with the same result. A third place to find the NPV function is on the command ribbon on the formulas tab. Here you can go to the function icon and then scroll down and find NPV. Note the cell I14 also provides the NPV. Why? Because cell I14 totals the individual discounted cash flows. This is the definition of NPV. Also note that cell H15 shows the NPV since it also sums the discounted cash flow. So several methods exist to determine the net present value from this spreadsheet. Another Excel formula for calculating the net present value is XNPV. In addition to the interest rate and cash flows, this formula uses dates. Microsoft designed XNPV to calculate the net present value for non-periodic cash flows, that is, cash flows spaced unevenly across time. We'll discuss this in a future video. Another widely used investment tool is Internal Rate of Return, or IRR. The Internal Rate of Return measures an investment's ability to repay capital. The Internal Rate of Return gauges the internal merits of a project. It tells you the rate at which a project generates money. This value is the compounded return rate, also called the investment yield. Manual calculation of IRR is difficult, but fortunately, Excel provides a built-in function. Again, referring to example 1, on sheet 1, the IRR function at cell C18 contains the values from the undiscounted cash flow at range C11 through H11. Freshly inserting the IRR function, Excel prompts you to enter the values and a guess. The values always consist of a series of raw, undiscounted cash flows, starting with the initial investment and continuing to the last period. Thus, the IRR function includes money invested or received at time zero. Excel's IRR function also asks for a guess, but this is optional and you can ignore the guess by leaving the argument blank. When you leave it blank, Excel uses 10% as the point where it begins its iterative calculation to find the IRR. To recap, we discussed cash flow, incremental analysis, net present value, and internal rate of return. The net present value is an extensive value, meaning the number gauges an opportunity's overall size. On the other hand, internal rate of return is an intensive measure, measuring an investment's generation of value. In the next video, we'll examine the benefit-cost ratio, maximum capital at risk, and payback. Click here for the next video. Or to learn more, go to ToweringSkills.com.